So that's now really a quick introduction. Let's run Atom GDB with my program. So first you need to open the project, which I just did by opening the directory. And then what you can do is, let's navigate to main again, we can insert a breakpoint. To do so though, you need to install the package Atom GDB. Let me show you how this works. You click on Edit Preferences, and then you click on Install, and then you can search for GDB, and you find the Atom, let me see, yeah, the DBG GDB, which is the interactive GDB debugger for Atom. Install this package. Yeah, once you've done it and you are in your source code, you can click here on packages debug. You find the debugging commands, or you just press F5, which is the typical command for a debugger. Okay, what I want to do here, I want to execute the program called main with the debugger. I type in the name of the file. I can also run choose files, and then I can press debug, and you see it actually produces our segmentation fault, and I actually can see where it produces the segmentation fault by clicking here on the call stack. So you find the same controls here as in GDB. We have information about the call stack, you have information about the variables. It's just a bit differently arranged, but the key ideas are similar or identical. It uses in fact GDB. So if I click here, I see that here is a problem, and now you can find out, it says it here the string comp is basically zero. So the pointer operation is zero. Why is it so? Because argv1 is pretty much invalid, and that produced this mistake. Okay, so I need to run it. Let me put stop. Run it with make it work. I have to again press F5, select here the program, and now I have to give him the arguments. We know we want to feed in mean 2 and 5. Let's run our program. Now this produced the output 3.0 that we knew, which is by the way wrong. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to create a breakpoint, and here it's as simple as clicking next to a line left of it on this red button basically, which inserts a breakpoint. Yeah. Now if I run my code again, here you go, the compiler has compiled my code before with debugging symbols, so now GDB knows it wants to break, you want to break at this line, line 17, so it will run all the commands until it reaches line 17, if at all. And now I can inspect the variables again. I see argv, you know what is in there. I can have a look at different variables, what is variable switcher, what is variable numbers, and so on and so forth. Yeah, and now you want to, you can basically control it by continue and so on, clicking one of those buttons, right? I can click step over, and you can see what it actually does, right? So you can see here in a very verbose form what is the result of this activity, which I think is quite instructive. Yeah, so that's a quite interesting alternative, and yeah, have a look and good luck with your debugging session. Yeah, understanding debuggers is really important, because you will have broken programs a lot during your career.